a bald Swedish man, and a desire to build fast cars. His name's Christian von Koenigsegg, and he builds his cars in a former airship hangar that was home to the Ghost Squadron Air Force. Much like the planes the Ghost Squadron used to fly, his cars are fast, very fast, stupid fast. 262 mile an hour fast. Still not convinced? Well, let me try to justify his $3.1 million price tag for you, starting with the engine. A 5-litre twin-turbo V8. Okay, so basically I've run out of time and motivation, so I've decided to just ditch that whole dialogue thing and just carry on like this. Now, the car, yes, very, very fast, that's about it. I mean, it's a Koenigsegg, it's Swedish. It's not like a Lamborghini or Ferrari that's like, ooh, all flamboyant. No, it's just an eggshell thing. Okay, not eggshell, but it looks like a very elegant spaceship that goes really, really fast. But stick drift tires on it, it does get sideways, but not that much. It's not what you would think 1100 horsepower feels like. In terms of sheer propulsion, and you look at the speedometer, yeah, it's really, really fast, but doesn't really feel like it. I think part of that is down to the gearing, which is very long, but of course it has to be long. It tops out at 7th at like 270, so it has to be. Other things is that it's pretty okay balance. If you were to slide it around, it's manageable, even being a mid-engine car. And something that helps with the sheer power is the differential. It's not your classic 40-20-20, it's a 15-100-20, if I'm not wrong. That helps with just putting down all of that 1100 horsepower while you're sideways, and it's pretty fun to slide around. It's pretty manageable, it's pretty easy, but you do have to watch it because it's a fat car, so you will get yourself at the curbs. Now down to the way it sounds, it's not boring. I mean, it sounds pretty epic, you get all those turbo noises and this deep throaty, but quite interesting sounding V8. It's not like American throaty V8, but it's not like screamy Italian V8, it's I guess Swedish IKEA V8? No. Oh yeah, and it's a convertible. And you can roll the windows down. Honestly, that's about it. It's not much of the car. It's cool. Is it worth $3.1 million? I guess. Because what you get with it is not only speed, but it's also rarity and exclusivity. As you know, not everyone has $3.1 million, but just saying, it's not as exciting or special to drive as you may think. But for impressing people, it's decent. It's good enough.